Let students start with the next topic of arithmetic progression. We have done how to find the nth term of an AP or how to find the position of an AP, how to find whether the given sequence is an AP. All this we have done. Now we are going to find out how we are going to add the terms of AP. Now we don't add the terms in between. We always take the term of first n or first n one like that. Suppose this is the AP that is given to us. The first three terms are given to us, A1, A2, A3 up to infinity. Is AP se hume pata lag raha hai that the first term is A1 and what is common difference? It will be A2 minus A1. How we can find the sum of first n terms? For जैसे n की जगह हम 5 बोल दें, what is the sum of first 5 terms? तो first 5 terms का sum मतलब है कि a1, a plus a2 plus a3 plus a4 plus a5 उसका sum क्या है? हम find out कर रहे हैं what is the sum of first n terms? That means n terms का किसका sum क्या है? इसको represent कैसे करते हैं? By sm. And what is the formula? This formula you have to remember. We are not deriving it. We are directly using the formula. N by 2, 2 into A plus N minus 1 into D. Is that clear? Now this N can be any. Hum do terms ka sum find out kar rahe hain. 3 ka, 4 ka, 5 ka. That can be any. Now suppose if the last term of the sequence is also given. First term ye hai, second term ye hai, third term ye hai. ये लास्ट टर्म है, देन हाउ डू वी फाइंड द सम? अगर हमें लास्ट टर्म भी दिया है, देन आल्सो वी नीड टू नो व्हाट इज द सम, व्हाट इज द पोजीशन ऑफ दिस पॉइंट एल. इसकी पोजीशन पहले फाइंड आउट करेंगे. सपोज इसकी पोजीशन क्या है? एन. पोजीशन ऑफ एल इज व्हाट? दैट इज एन. Then you can say, instead of sum of first n terms, we can write sum of these terms. So suppose we are given a sequence जिसमें last term भी given है और हमें कहा गया है कि इन सबको add करो. इन सबको add करने के लिए हमें ये formula apply करना पड़ता है, n by 2 a plus l. What is a first term? What is l last term? But for this formula, what is n? n कैसे पता लगेगा? n is always the position of the last term. So there are two formulas. Either of the formula can be used. जो first formula है, it can be used both for first and second type. लेकिन जो last term वाला formula है, that can be used if and only if the last term is given. Otherwise not. Yes, students, come to the exercise 10B. See the first question. The first question is you have to find the sum of these terms. The terms are 2 plus 7 plus 12 and how many terms are there? There are 19 terms. Isme hame last term nahi di hai, so we will use the first formula and there are no marks for writing the formula. Directly we have to do the substitution. Uske liye pehle hame chahiye A. What is the first term? That is 2. Then we need common difference. Common difference kya hai? Second term minus first term. That is equal to 5. Uske baad hai n. Kitne terms ka humne sum find out karna hai? 19. 19 terms ko add karna hai. So what is the sum of these 19 terms? The formula is, let me write a general formula to make it. The sum of n terms is given by this. So we just have to substitute the values here. This is 19 by 2. Then this is 2 into A, n minus 1 into D, and D is how much? That is 5. So let us check it, find the answer. This is 4 plus 18 into 5 into 94. This is 47, so hence the answer comes out to be 893. So quite simple, very easy question. Okay, let us see, this was the first question. Now let us see the third question which we have written here. We are given this series, minus 11 plus minus 7 minus 3 and up to 12 terms. the same type of question. We have to find the sum. Last term given नहीं है, लेकिन हमें ये given है कितने terms का sum find out करना है n. So we will use the same formula. What is a? The first term minus 11. What is d? D is second term minus first. Second term minus first. So it is equal to 4. And what is n here? There are 12 terms. So what is the sum of these 12 terms? It is n by 2 into 2 into a plus n minus 1 into d. Quite simple formula. This is 6 minus 22 plus 44. That is minus 6 into, sorry, this is 6 into 22, and hence the answer is 132. So quite simple to substitute the form. Students, come to the next question. We are given the 8th question. We have to find the sum of these terms till minus 62. We have to find the sum of these terms. अब इसमें क्या है, what is the difference between them? यहाँ पर हमें last term भी given है, ये नहीं given है कि कितने terms हैं, but first term और last term that is given. Now a is what, minus 5, and what is the last term, that is minus 62. जब हमारे पास last term होती है, we can use both the formulas. It is our choice whichever we feel easier. We can find the answer by both. दोनों के लिए हमें n की value चाहिए. Now, if I'm using the second formula was like this. It is n by 2 into a plus l. So, a I know, l I know, but I don't know what is the value of n. N क्या होता है? N is the position of the last term. How do we find the position? Position is always given by this formula. A is equal to n minus 1 into d. Term हमें पता है minus 62. First term is minus 5, n we don't know. And what is d here? D is second term minus the first term, which is equal to minus 3. Second term minus the first term, minus 8 plus 5, that is minus 3. So this is minus 57 minus 3n plus 3, which means that n is equal to 20. So now what is the position of this last term? It is 20. That means we have to find the sum of the 20 terms. So what is the sum? It is 20 by 2. First term is minus 5. Last term is minus 62. 10 into minus 67. And hence the answer is minus 670. So quite an easy question. Come to the 9th question. In the 9th question, we have been given, find the sum of all 2-digit natural numbers which are divisible by 5. Jitne bhi 2-digit natural numbers hain divisible by 5, we have to find them. Ab jaise 5 hai, it is divisible by 5, but it is 1-digit natural number. The first, so we can write here, first of all, the 2-digit natural numbers which are divisible by 5, are, first kaun sa hai, 10, uske baad aata hai 15, ye 2-digit natural numbers hain which are divisible by 5, last pe kaun sa hai, 100 kya hai, 3-digit, to 100 se pehle 2-digit kaun sa hai, 95. So, ye wo 2-digit natural numbers hain which are divisible by 5. The question is, we have to find the sum. To uske liye hum ye formula use kar sakte hain, because we know the first term, we know the last term. But we don't know that what is the position of the last term. So, here you can see that this sequence forms an AP, because the common difference of two consecutive terms is 5. Here A is 10. Common difference is how much? 15 minus 10, that is 5. And the last term is 95. So let us find the position of the last term. It is given by TN is a plus n minus 1 into b. So from here we are getting that n is equal to 17. If n is equal to 17, then what is the sum? Sum is given by n by 2 into, no, it will be 18, because 18 divided by 5 plus 1, n is equal to 18. So sum will be n by 2 into a plus l. That is 9 into 105. That is equal to 945. So, पहले हमने लिखे the two digit numbers which are divisible by 5. अगर आपने यहीं पर गलती कर दी है, that means the whole question will be wrong. The first and the last number must be written properly. उसके बाद we have to find a sum. We know the first term, we know the last term. We calculated n from the last term. And hence we got the formula for sum n by 2 into a plus l. And the sum comes out to be 945. Yes, the next question is, we have to find the sum of all the even numbers between 10 and 20. In these type of questions, this number, this should be read properly, that is between. So between ka matlab hai 10 or 100 included nahi hai. All the numbers starting from 11 to 99. 10 and 100 are not included because we have been asked to find the sum of the numbers between 10 and 100. So first of all, we will write down all the even numbers between 10 and 100. Which is the first even number after 10? That is 12. Then you have 14. Which is the last even number before 100? It is 98. So these is the sequence that we have been given. We have to find its sum. Now here, in this sequence, what is the first term? 12. What is the common difference? It is 2. And what is the last term? It is 98. So to find the sum, we need to find out n. N is the position of the last term. How do we find out n? Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So there is no need to write the formula again because we know it already. So this is, it is 2n minus 2. Hence, n is equal to 44. So, this is the value of n, that is 44. So, what is the sum? Sum is given by n by 2 into a plus l. So, it is n by 2 a plus l. So, this is 110. And hence, we can multiply and then write down the answer. Can multiply and write down the answer. Okay, students, come to the next question. That is the 13th question. Here we are given the fourth term of an AP is 22. 15th term of an AP is 66. You have to find the first term, common difference, and hence the sum of the series. So we write here, let the first term be A and let the common difference be D. First of all, we suppose this, let the first term be A and common difference be D. Now the fourth term of an AP is 22. How do we write the fourth term? Fourth term ko likhte hain A plus 3D. Because fourth term is written as A plus N minus 1 into D. So 4 minus 1 kitna ho gaya? 3D. So ye formula humne yahan par kaun sa use kiya hai? This one. AN is A plus N minus 1 into D. This is a formula we have used. So fourth term kya aayega? A plus 4 minus 1 into D. Then we are given the 15th term is 66. This is the 15th term. Now we have to find A and D. So we subtract them. when you subtract, you get that is 11d is 44, which means that d is equal to 4. So from the first equation, we can find out a plus 12 is 22, which means that a is equal to 10. So hence we have got the first term and we have got the common difference. Quite easy. Now the next part is we have to find out what is the sum of first 8 terms of the series. Now we will use the formula. That is, let me write the formula. Formula which we have been using earlier, 2a plus n minus 1 into b. Here we have to find the sum of 8 terms. So 8 by 2, 2 into a plus n minus 1, and d here is 4. So this is 20. And this is 7 into 4, 28, 4 into 48, that is 192. So, quite simple. We have calculated the first term, common difference, and hence the sum of first 8. You students, see this question. It is written that the production of TV sets in a factory increases uniformly by a fixed number every year. It produced 8,000 sets in the 6th year and 11,300 in the 9th year. Find the production in 1st year, 8th year and 6th years. So 8th year means different and 6th years means different. 8th year ka matlab hai ki sirf 8th year mein kitni production hui hai. 6th years means that is from 1st to 6th. The whole 6 years, total 6 years mein kitni production hui hai. So we are given only two things. How much is the production in the 6th year and how much is the production in the 9th year. So how we are going to do it? First of all, we write here that let the production in the 1st year be A. First year mein kitni production hui hai? A. And let it increase by D every year. So, हमें इस question को एक AP में convert करना है. After converting it into AP, we have to find this. AP के लिए दो important चीजें क्या हैं? First term and common difference. Both are not given. इसमें first term क्या है? First year में कितनी production हुई, that is the first term. We are taking it as A. हर साल जो production है, वो increase हो रही है by fixed number. अगर first year में 100 increase हुई है, तो second year में भी 100 है. That is the common difference. तो हमने common difference D लिया है, that is the increase in production every year. Now we are given, sixth year की production है 8,000. Now we know that the nth term is always given by this n minus 1 into d. So sixth term kya hoga? Sixth term is first term plus 5d. A plus n minus 1 into d. Now then it is given that in the ninth year the production is 11,300 in the ninth year. Ninth year means n is 9. That is 8 into D. So we subtract the first equation from the second equation. We are getting 3D. And this is 3300, which means that D is 1100. So 6th year ki production, 9th year ki production. So when we solve them, we are getting D. And how we can find out A? From the second equation, you can find out A. Or from the first equation also. Let us find it from first equation. 5000 is equal to A plus 8000 is equal to this is 5500. So that means A is how much? It is 0, 0 and this is 5 and 2500. So from here we conclude that what is the production in the first year? First year mein kitni production hui hai, that is 2500. The first part answer, 2500 is the production in the first year. लेट अस फाइंड आउट द आंसर फॉर द सेकेंड पार्ट कि एट ईयर में कितनी प्रोडक्शन हुई है. एट ईयर की वैल्यू कैसे आएगी फ्रॉम दिस फॉर्मूला. ये है प्रोडक्शन इन द एंथ ईयर. सो एट ईयर इज ए प्लस दैट इज एट माइनस वन इंटू डी. What is A here? A we have calculated 2500 and plus 7 into D which is 1100. So 2500 plus 7700, how much is it? It is 10,200. Then third part, we have to calculate how much is the production in 6 years. अब यहाँ पर ये ही लिखा है व्हाट इज द प्रोडक्शन इन द सिक्स्थ ईयर. अगर सिक्स्थ ईयर लिखा होता वी वुड हैव यूज्ड दिस फॉर्मूला. उसी ईयर में कितनी प्रोडक्शन हुई है. बट इट इज रिटन व्हाट इज द प्रोडक्शन इन सिक्स ईयर. दैट मीन्स वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट हाउ मच इज द प्रोडक्शन इन द सिक्स ईयर. व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला. एन बाई टू, टू इंटू ए. ए इज हाउ मच 2500 प्लस एन माइनस वन एंड डी इज हाउ मच 1100. So it is 3, this is 5000 plus 5500, this is 10,500 which is 31500. So this is the production in the 6th year. Can check the calculations and hence the answer. So jo statement thi usko humne AP mein convert kiya and we have calculated प्रोडक्शन इन फर्स्ट ईयर, कॉमन डिफरेंस प्रोडक्शन इन एट ईयर एंड देन इन द सिक्स ईयर्स. स्टूडेंट्स कम टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. वी आर गिवन दैट 200 लॉग्स आर स्टैक्ड इन सच अ वे दैट देयर आर 20 लॉग्स इन द बॉटम रो, 19 लॉग्स इन द नेक्स्ट रो, 18 लॉग्स इन द नेक्स्ट रो एंड सो ऑन. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट हाउ मेनी रोज आर फॉर्मड एंड हाउ मेनी लॉग्स आर देयर इन द टॉप रो. So let us analyze the question. Total हमारे पास कितने logs हैं? 200. Now first row में कितने हैं? You can take this as a first row from the bottom. You can take the first row from the top. Last row में कितने logs हैं? 20. उसके ऊपर 19. Then it is 18. Then there are so many rows. We don't know how many rows are there. We also don't know how many logs are there on the topmost row or you can say the last row. But the total number of logs that have been stacked, they are 200. So how we can find out the number of rows and the last. We suppose this thing, let the number of logs in the last row. Isko hum first maan rahe hain. Ye jo top pe hai, isko hum last suppose kar rahe hain. So let the number of logs in the last row be X. And let us suppose that the number of the rows, ये जो rows हैं 1, 2, 3, 4, तो हमने suppose किया ये n है. Total logs कितने हैं? 200. वो कैसे हैं? ये logs add करके 20 plus 19 plus 18 and so on. जो last पे हैं कितने logs हैं? X. So let us use the formula. We know that what is the formula when first and last term is given? It is given by n by 2 a plus l. यहाँ पर n क्या है? n इज द पोजिशन ऑफ द लास्ट टर्म एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी सपोज दैट द पोजिशन दिस इज द nth रो. सो हेंस वी आर गेटिंग 400 इज 20n प्लस दैट इज 20n एंड प्लस दैट इज x इंटू n. दिस इज द एक्सप्रेशन वी आर गेटिंग. नाउ वी हैव टू सॉल्व इट फर्दर. Now how we can find out x? We know one formula that tn is a plus n minus 1 into d. Now what is the last that is x? A is how much? 20. N is the position of the last row and what is d? 19 minus 20 minus 1. So this 20 minus n plus 1 is x. That means x is 21 minus n. So, यहाँ पर हमने मल्टीप्लाई किया था. देयर इज नो नीड टू मल्टीप्लाई. वी कैन कीप इट एज इट इज. लेट अस सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स. इट इज 21 माइनस एन. सो इट इज एन इंटू 41 माइनस एन. वी आर गेटिंग दैट एन स्क्वायर माइनस 41 एन प्लस 400 इज इक्वल टू जीरो. लेट अस सॉल्व इट फर्दर. इट इज एन स्क्वायर -16n -25n +400 is equal to 0. When you solve it, you are getting n is equal to 16 and 25. You know how to solve the quadratic equation. So, ek equation hamare paas aayi thi by using the sum. The second equation is by using the value of nth term. Then we are getting a quadratic equation and we are getting two values of n, that is 16 and 25. Let us check, are both the values correct or not. Now, if n is 25, let us find out what is the value of x. X will be equal to 20 minus, that is 24 into minus 1, which means 20 minus 24, which is minus 4. अगर हम n को 25 लेते हैं तो हमारे पास आता है यहाँ पर कितने logs हैं, minus 25. Now number of logs cannot be negative. So therefore this n is equal to 16. N cannot be 25. Why is it so? If I'm putting n here, I'm getting that number of logs here is minus 4. That has no meaning. So n is 16. And therefore what is x? It is 20 plus 16 minus 1 minus 1. 20 minus 15, which is equal to 5. That is the number of logs in the last row is 5 and number of rows are 16.